Hello everybody, Teagan here with High Point Scientific. I want to welcome you to our next episode of What is in the Night Sky this month. Tonight, I will be taking you through a beautiful tour of the night sky in the month of July. Tonight, we're going to be visiting the planets, the moon, as well as some beautiful deep sky objects that are prominent this month for both visual astronomers and astrophotographers. So as always, buckle in and let's see what's really out there. To start off this tour, we're going to travel 26,000 light years past our solar system, and we're going to visit a globular cluster, and one of the finest globular clusters in the northern hemisphere, Messier 13, otherwise known as the Great Hercules Cluster. M13 is conveniently located between Eta and Zeta Hercules. You should be able to spot the cluster with binoculars even under a rather light polluted sky, but if your skies are bad, you'll probably only see a small, faint, misty circular patch. Larger binoculars will help you discern the cluster's bright core. Turn a telescope to this cluster and you are in for a treat. This is one cluster that is very easily resolvable and really fires up your imagination. A low magnification will show the cluster's large core extending some way towards the edge. Increase the magnification to around 75 times, and you'll start to resolve the individual stars. Now take your time when you're viewing this cluster through a telescope to really let your eyes soak in the view. Some visual astronomers like to refer to these globular clusters as diamonds on a black velvet background. A splendid and spectacular view through a telescope. The next deep sky object on our list tonight is arguably a favorite among amateur astrophotographers. It is bright, it is very detailed, and it is gorgeous to photograph. Messier 8, the Lagoon Nebula. While bright enough to be seen with the naked eye, Messier 8 is best seen with binoculars or a telescope. After the Orion Nebula, Messier 8 is arguably one of the most stunning nebula to view in the Northern Hemisphere. Small telescopes will reveal a greenish tint, while larger equipment will show some texture, details, and using an O3 filter will help to bring out some of these finer details. After viewing the Lagoon Nebula, we are going to bring it back quite a ways, and we're going to check out the solar system and see what the planets and the moon are up to. Mercury is visible about 15 to 20 minutes before sunrise for the first week of the month, and then it reappears in the evening twilight for the last 4 or 5 days. A beautiful crescent moon hangs to its upper right on July 29th. Saturn rises around 10 p.m., then followed by Neptune just around midnight. Neptune spends its month in Pisces on the border with Aquarius. It's also moving backwards like Saturn, but unlike Saturn, you will need binoculars or a telescope to spot it. It will dip back into Aquarius next month, and it will remain there for the rest of the year. Jupiter rises less than an hour after Neptune and can be found in Cetus, the whale. Mars, still relatively faint but growing brighter, can be seen in the hours after midnight and is edging towards Uranus. Mars and Uranus will appear within the same binocular field of view on the 23rd and onward. The waning crescent moon appears very close to Mars on July 21st and then a degree from Uranus the next morning. Venus remains easily visible for the last 90 minutes before sunrise, with the crescent moon nearby on July 26th. Lastly, the moon turns full on July 13th and new on the 28th. We are going to head back out into deep space, and we're going to visit Messier 24, otherwise known as the Sagittarius Star Cloud, a beautiful object for both visual astronomers and astrophotographers. Messier 24 is a huge group of stars scattered across 600 light years of space. M24 is visible to the naked eye, but it is much better observed with binoculars or a telescope with a low magnification, a wide-angle eyepiece specifically. Regular 10x50 binoculars will show a misty cloud made up of hundreds of unresolved stars. Telescopically, M24 can be an absolute stunning sight. Look out for NGC 6603 as well, a small star cluster just a little to the north of Messier 24's core. The next deep sky object is not a nebula, nor is it a star cluster, but rather a double star, Rasalgethi or Alpha Hercules. This is a fine double for telescopic observers. A modest magnification of 50 times is just enough to resolve its components. The primary star appears golden, with a close, fainter white secondary star that occasionally shows hints of pale blue or even lime green. Moving on from this double star, we're going to head into another Messier object, Messier 17, otherwise known as the Swan Nebula. Found on the border of Scutum, M17's shape is apparent through almost any telescope at low power. Although the Swan's body is typically easier to see than its head, increasing the magnification to over 100 times will show some texture at the nebula's base. We recommend you use an O3 filter to help increase contrast and improve the view of some of the structures within the Swan Nebula. Well, that is it for tonight's tour of the night sky in July. We thank you so much for tuning in. If you have any questions at all, please let us know in the comments. And if you've ever photographed or viewed any of these objects through a telescope or binoculars, please let us know in the comments. We would love to hear your backstory. Again, we thank you so much for tuning in. My name is Teagan, and you have been watching High Point Scientific, What is in the Night Sky? We hope to see you next month.